Welcome to Jesus TV, the home of love, the home of God. Today we're going to discuss about the crucifixion of Jesus Christ and the real Jesus. So from the crucifixion to the resurrection. How do you know the real Jesus now? Please, if you have not subscribed to my channel, can you do me a favor? Click the subscription button. Share this video to reach others that we all can learn together and move together and grow together spiritually and improve ourselves physically and spiritually and mentally. This year, 2024, I love you all, my viewers. Please share this video, subscribe and like it. Welcome to Jesus TV. You'll be surprised. So our topic today is from the crucifixion of Jesus to the resurrection. How do you know the real Jesus? Yes. Everyone in the gospel describe the crucifixion in different ways. Some describe the crucifixion of Jesus in their own way. There are definite similarities. Yes. But such highlights differentiate the moment that gives us full and complex picture of what happened when Jesus died on the cross. Yeah, let me get it. In Matthew 27, there's a strange description. Jesus cries out with a loud voice and gives us his spirit. Verse 15. Immediately following his willing death, giving his internal and divine life for the dying world, a number of things happened. Immediately Christ died. See, the Bible said that a number of things happened as soon as Christ breathed his last breath, giving out his divine life. Remember, the death of Christ is willing. As soon as he breathed his last breath, many things happened. There was an earthquake everywhere. The temple, according to the Bible, was teared from the top to the bottom. Those who are dead in Christ, who are believers in Jesus and in God, who have died even before the death of Christ. As soon as Christ died, give out his ghost willingly. All of them, their grave was open. The cemetery where they were buried, the grave was made open as soon as Christ died. That's what the Bible said. As soon as Jesus died, the grave was open. And they all rises from their graves. But one thing is very simple and understanding. They did not go to the city. They did not rise for the world to see them as soon as Jesus died. They waited in the various cemetery until Christ rises from the grave. It was until when Christ rise from the grave, that's where all of them went to the city and begin to preach Jesus. And begin to preach the testimony of Jesus. And begin to talk about all the whole truth of what they know about Christ. In Matthew 27, he said, there is a strange description. Jesus cries out with a loud voice and gives his spirit in verse 50. See, immediately, following his willing death, giving his eternal and divine life for the dying world, a number of things happened. The veil in the temple before the Holy of Holies tears from the bottom. The Bible Bible said there was earthquake. Rock splitting into two. Centuries testified that Jesus was righteous. And Jesus was the Son of God. Check the book of Luke 23, verse 47. Mark 15, verse 39. So, what are we saying? That from the resurrection, from the death of Christ to the resurrection, Jesus remains one. In the beginning, Jesus was operating in human form. As soon as he gives up his divine power, he becomes God. The real Jesus is God Himself. So, among these traumatic events, dead people get out of graves and start walking around. That's one thing I want you to understand. Dead people, they will get out of their grave and start walking around as soon as Jesus rises from the grave. So that's the point I want us to understand today. At that moment, the curtain in the sanctuary of the temple was torn into two, from the top to the bottom. The earth shook. Rocks split apart. Tombs opened. The bodies of many who have died, many who are men of God, who have died in the past, were raised from the dead. They left the cemeteries after their resurrection and went into Jerusalem and appeared to many people. According to the book of Matthew 27, from verse 51 to 53, so, Jesus is always Lord. Why these people were resurrected at this crucifixion day? They didn't leave the cemetery. Remember one point I want you to understand. Why these people were resurrected on the resurrection day? They didn't leave the cemetery until the resurrection day. Until 3 days after Christ died. Remember, they were resurrected on the day Jesus died, but they could not leave the cemetery until the day Jesus rose from the dead. That was the day all of them left the cemetery and went into the city to testify. Because cemeteries weren't in the city for proper or various reasons in those days. And in those days, touching of the dead bodies is like a taboo. The Jews don't touch dead bodies those days. If anybody mistakenly touched dead body, the person have to wait for 7 days for cleansing before he or she can touch the dead body. That's how it was in those days. Check the book of Numbers 11, Numbers 19. To 13. Numbers 19 from verse 11 to 13. So with that in mind, other species and health issues, cemeteries were away from the main population of the Jews those days. So they didn't touch dead bodies. So the question today is, who were these people? Those people that rises from the dead the day Jesus died. Who are they? That's the question we need to answer. And the very big question we need to ask ourselves. Who are they? Those people that rise from the grave the day Jesus died. Who are they? Matthew, the book of Matthew makes it very clear. They were godly men and women. They had followed God faithfully before their death. They were godly men and women. They have followed God faithfully before their death. Now, where did they go? They went into the most holy of holy, the city of Jerusalem, the King David's city, where God was said to dwell, and the home of the temple of God. Another question that come up is, what did they do? Remember, we are talking about those people that raised from the dead on the day Christ died. We are trying to know, identify the people there. Remember, they were dead. Godly men and women. Now the question is, what did they do? They appeared to the people, giving testimonies to the miracle that had happened. They appeared to me and you. They appear to millions of people in a city, giving testimonies about Christ, giving testimony about the resurrection of Jesus, giving testimony about what had happened. And because of them, that made me and you today to stand, proclaim Jesus, to talk about Jesus, that Jesus have raised from the dead. Jesus have died. He have raised from the dead for the sake of me and you. Inside this sinful world. So Jesus remains God, and Jesus is God. That's what the Bible was saying. The next question is, what happened to these people? These are the people, what happened to them? The Bible doesn't tell us. We can speculate on what happened, but the Bible did not tell us at all. Bible did not make any explanation. The Bible recorded few things about them. Another sign of importance of resurrection to Jesus was when Martha talks to him before Christ and Lazarus from the dead. Martha is sad. Jesus comforted him. Jesus answered, I am the resurrection and death. The life. Remember, you see, I am the resurrection and death. Say that I am the resurrection and life. John 11:25. The resurrection isn't only an event, something in the future. It is a person. The reality and the truth of that person, Jesus revealed through the body and resurrection of saints from the dead. And the promise of immortality that only happens when Jesus is immortal. Jesus is the resurrection. Today, I'm encouraging you, my people. The real truth of whom Jesus is that Jesus is Lord. Jesus is God. God told us that He is the resurrection and death. He is the one that rise, and He is the one that is still alive. He is the one that died, remember, and He is the one that rise again. In all, they are all God. God is the resurrection and death. Jesus is the resurrection and death. That's why in my culture, we say that Jesus the mobility normal. Jesus is the one that was crucified. Jesus the one that rise. And Jesus the one that is dead. And all are God. God is the resurrection and death. And Jesus is God. Now, the real Jesus man inside this story is God. As soon as he crucified his mortal body and entered into divinity, those who have died, who are in Christ, the men and the women who are in Christ, all of them rise from the grave. On the third day, when Christ rose from the dead, they all rise and enter into the city of Jerusalem and begin to preach Christ and begin to preach the world what have happened. You begin to teach the world what have happened according to the Bible, according to the eyewitness, because they too, they were miracle of the same resurrection. They were part of the same resurrection. So that's why they were able to preach about it with all vim and all faith. They were able to preach about Christ without fear. They were able to preach about the resurrection of Christ without any menacing word. They were able to say the truth as it was to all the whole generation of the earth. So today, I encourage you that Jesus Christ is God. Just as the Bible says that in the beginning was the Word was with God, and that Word was God, and all things were made was made with Him. So I encourage whoever that is listening to me today, believe in Christ with all your heart. Believe in your God, because He is the creator of heaven and earth. Without Him, nothing was made that was made. He is the way, the truth, and life. The Bible said that no one comes to Him, to the Father, except through God. His coming into the world is to cleanse me and you of our sins. And He remains God, who died to save humanity. Please, if you have not subscribed to our channel, please kindly do us a favor. Subscribe to this channel. Share this video to get more people that the real Christ is God. And God is the real Christ. From the crucifixion to the resurrection, the real Jesus is God. From the beginning to the end, the crucifixion to the resurrection, the real Christ is God. That's why we say that He is the resurrection, He is death. I encourage you, make the word of God a compass. In this year 2024, all roads will be open for you. Every road that looks crooked will be made smooth. Make Jesus your everything. Make Jesus your all. To you who is watching me now, I want to pray for you before I close this video. May every crooked way in your life be made open in the name of Jesus Christ. May everything that you are lacking, today I command them to come to you in 1,000,000-fold in the name of Jesus Christ. I decree healing upon your life, whatever way that you may be experiencing pain in any part of your body. The Bible says that as our faces differ one by one, so as our problem differs. I decree healing upon your life. I decree healing upon your body. I decree healing upon your bone. I declare healing upon your blood system. Let there be a new body in the name of Jesus Christ. Let there be a new bloodstream in your body in the name of Jesus. Let there be a new beginning in everything you do. Let there be a new beginning. Let there be a new womb. Let there be a new job. Let there be a new business. A new contract. a new beginning this year 2024. May your life be new in Jesus' name. Amen. Good morning and happy new year. God bless you from Jesus' name. I love you all. Please subscribe to my channel and share this video to your friends. God bless you.